Okay. Oh,
it's time to light this shit.
Activate interceptors now.
Where'd you learn to fight like that?
Low school. Steal a car. Go to hell.
I've been looking all over for you.
You've been looking in the wrong places.
Jean-Claude Van Damme, 33 jaar. Ooit een echte Brusselaar, nu een Hollywoodster van formaat. Filmnet mocht hem even storen tijdens een vakantie in het zonnige Antibes. En daar hadden we een goede reden voor. Deze maand kan je namelijk twee Van Damme films bekijken. Universal Soldier en Double Impact.
Everything started at the age of 11. I started martial arts. And it really helped me physically and mentally to become very strong. My parents, they own a flower shop, and also my father was an accountant on the side. So I was well raised by my parents, and then at the age of 18, 17, I own a gym. Was always into training and always dreaming about movies, but it's very difficult to make in Belgium because they're producing at that time maybe like a movie every 3 years.
It looks pretty mean to me. And tough.
I decided to leave, and I left Belgium around the age of 20. When I came in LA, it was no contact. I didn't speak English at all. No papers, immigration papers, so I was on my own. And that's why I believe I made it, because the mental strength, mental power from karate, from any sport, if it's tennis or volleyball or martial art, I was establishing to myself a goal, and it really helped me. Day and night to try to, without insisting too much, on a classy way, because if you're doing, you have different way to do it. I mean, some people, they'll disturb you until something happens, and that's bad. You have to do everything on a nice way. But finally a guy gave me a chance after five or six years of pushing hard, you know. I met Mr. Golan, who was a producer, and when I show up in his office, I did a exhibition in his own office. But it was like a low budget company with low budget movies, so it's so far away from it.
Oh, it still hurts.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay, maybe you should relax now.
Okay.
Slowly, close your legs. Beautiful. Doing well. You know, stretching is so important. For example, because of my big legs and karate, I can do the splits no problem.
But now, I'm taking much more time for movies now I will do one film a year. Now I'm going to be very careful on stories and script, and also choosing good directors. And now they're spending more money for my movies. I made movies for like $2 million. And now my next movie will cost $35 million. So it's a different type of business.
How do you pick your new projects now? What is the main reason to do a movie? Is it the scenario? Is it the other actors, the director?
The main reason, the story. Script, script, and script. And when you have a good script, you have good directors because they like the story. Before, movies like Bloodsport, Kickboxer, even Double Impact, they're good movies, but I wrote them myself with friends. I wasn't able to find a good script because good scripts are busy with big movie stars. And now I proved myself. My movies made money. Now I'm more bankable, so I can go with good stories. But it's difficult to find a good story.
I think she likes it.
Alex, it's not what it seems.
You shut up. Alex, cool down. Chill out, Belle. Chill out, okay? Chill out. Chill out. Chill out. Mr. California. Mr. Silk Underwear. Mr. Perfection. You wanna see with chill out in Hong Kong?
You're drunk, Alex. You're drunk. Now stop it!
Think about it. I was waiting for that.
Alex.
Come on. Come on!
I think it's great. And also Double Impact, I make fun of myself. You have Chad who's like a comic from LA with Leo Tarr, who's doing karate. He's a funny guy from Malibu Beach somewhere. And then you have Alex, who's like a tough guy, and we can see the difference between Chad and Alex. And I wrote the script in 10 days with Sheldon. In 10 days, that's 10 pages a day, and that's very difficult. And the shooting was so hard because it was a low budget, but it looked very big on the screen. And I was working about 17 hours a day doing twins, changing from one guy to the other guy, shaving, putting a fake one here, putting some tan, being white, clothing.
In that movie, yeah.
Difficult.
We have that movie on Filmnet in June. There are some very impressive fighting scenes between the two brothers.
Yeah,
how did you do the choreography of all of that?
I've got a guy who looked like me from behind, even from the front, from long distance, like 30 feet. I've got some doubles I was fighting with. We only see the back of them. I've got split screen, motion control, different effect. Then we can see two Jean-Claude on the screen. So it's kind of funny.
Wasn't it difficult for you to fight yourself or imagine how the other person would move?
Well, we did different types of fighting. One was fighting very fair, and one was fighting like street. So it's like to see a young Jean-Paul Belmondo with a young Alain Delon. You know, two different types of guys.
One praise for the speedy and precise handling of the terrorist situation. In a related story, only hours after the rescue at the Kinley Dam, news reporters become newsmakers. Reporting live from the scene, Chris Garfield.
In a surprising development, a CNA cameraman, Huey Taylor, was shot and killed in a motel room in neighboring Eagle Rock City. Witnesses allege that Veronica Roberts, a CNA correspondent, shot him after an apparent argument. No. Cocaine and other narcotics were found at the scene.
No way. No way.
They are not going to get away with this, man. This is crazy.
You must return to your room.
Conspiracy? I mean, we're crying out loud.
Mother?
Come here.
Work in this godforsaken place.
This area is not secure.
You know what? Why don't you... What are you doing?
It's not safe for you to hear.
Wear your clothes.
I have to cool down.
My God, you're burning up.
Shame on you.
Women love those movies. I mean that movie, because I'm not a fighter. I'm trying to get away from the bad guys. I know I'm also in deep trouble with myself because I'm supposed to die soon. We don't know the ending yet, but I mean, and I'm running away with a reporter, a female, a lady reporter, and I'm like a baby. I need protection. I'm like naked to the world. So, naked mentally. So Dolph is like that big machine. So that's why women love that movie so much, Soldier. They love Soldier. Lots of ladies. I've got so many fans. Plus, it's a good look. It's my first semi-big production in America.
How was it like working with Dolph?
Nice. A great guy. Very shy. People, they have a wrong image. I mean, people told me he will have problems on the set because he doesn't talk much, he's a strong guy, he will fight and blah, blah, blah. You know, like in Hollywood, blah, 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 always blah, blah, blah. And when I was on the set, all the blah, blah, blah was worth nothing. The guy was great.
They're entering the drain-off tunnels.
GR-13, take aim and hold fire.
Checkpoint 1 all clear.
Checkpoint 2 all clear.
GR-44 is in position. Take aim, fire. Move in and secure the objective.
Hey, Dolph, stop eating that much. You always stole my food and breakfast and everything.
Hey, you got enough money to pay for all this? You know, money, cash, dollars, dinero.
The question is, how are you going to pay for it?
I don't know.
You don't know. Ain't that cute? I'm going to bust your head, punk.
I don't want to hurt you.
Me? You don't hurt Hank?
I eat normal when I'm on vacation, like now. I go easy on training. I do more running and bicycle, everything for the heart. They call that cardiovascular. And when I'm preparing a movie, then I start to train hard, like a competition. Like 3 months before, I start to go with dumbbells and everything, and I can put on weight so fast.
Where do you train?
My house.
You have your
or
own...
Or on location.
With a personal trainer, or you know enough about it to set up your own program?
I know enough about it. You see, I know my body so well now. It's like I can put on 10 pounds in 3 months of muscle. Naturally.
Go! Get out!
which actor or actress would you really like to work with?
If I could pick, I think a great actor is Pacino. I think he's fantastic as a male actor. I like his face and his emotion. He can be very upset and very passionate.
An actress?
An actress. Why am I going for the best? Actress, so many good actresses. I like Kim Basinger or Michelle Pfeiffer.
Why them in specifically?
Because, you see, you have so many actresses and they are so good, but it's difficult to find those beautiful movie stars like the old time, like Raquel Welch and Lola Brigida. I mean, it's nice to act, but if you have a good face too, I mean,
it helps.
That's a selfish note from my mouth, but beauty, I mean, they call them movie stars, and when you see those beautiful ladies, it's an inspiration of being a woman. It's like, you know, they can act, but also Pfeiffer and Kim Basinger have those beautiful look. Yeah.
Do you want me to go?
Yes. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what I want. I don't know what I'm
doing. A lot of your audience also consists of women.
Yes.
You're one of the only action heroes that can claim that, a big female audience.
Right.
How do you explain that?
I don't know. Why kids like Michael Jackson? He's got some magic with them. Why kids love me? I've got so many kids that love me More adult people love Steven Seagal. Why? I don't know.
It's just part
of... Same with women. I don't know. Maybe it's something sexy in the air. I mean, Richard Gere, why women love him so much? I mean, he's not that very handsome, but he's very sexy. Why? I don't know.
So it could be the company...
If I knew, I would own 10 companies.
Why don't you do yourself a favor, boy?
I think the favor gonna be done for you.
It's okay. Now take your big stick and your boyfriend and find the best to catch.
Oh, this guy's funny.
I just finished a great movie, Time Cop,
yes.
A science fiction film, and we did some test in Los Angeles in a theater, and it was huge. And never in my career those tests were so high, and that will be my very, I believe, first successful, very commercial film in domestic, and of course I'm very big and foreign.
Yes. Can you tell us a little bit about that movie?
Yeah, that's a cop who's they have those machines, they can go to the past. It's in 2010, 2008. And they have those time cop, those cop they are trained to go back in the past to stop people who use those machines to change the past to make a lot of money or profit in the future. But also I lost my wife in the movie. It's like a ghost story with action in the past. It's a big love affair, very sensual, lots of action. And at the end it's beautiful, it's very sad. People were crying on the test screening, so it's like... No, because normally movies I made before were like for the action audience. And I've got so many ladies, they want to see me in different types of movies. So Time Cop has very branches, lots of arms. The Time Cop is touching the female, the male, the young kids. It's doing well.
We're all alone, no chaperone, can't get our number. The world's in slumber, let's misbehave. There's something wild about your child that's so contagious. Let's be outrageous.
Doing, partner?
Ex-partner.
Let me go, Max. Look, I'm not hurting anybody.
Got to take you back.
In the year 2004, time travel is a reality.
You're charged with violations of TEC code 40.8, time travel with intent to alter the future.
And a crime.
It turns out going back in time is a pretty easy way to make money.
I think you got yourself a shipment of gold and you're taking a General Lee.
Already out of the bottle. The technology is there.
Now, one man.
You ever hear the name Aaron McComb?
Is about to take the ultimate power trip.
He's gonna be president.
You don't need the press, you don't need endorsements, you don't even need the truth. You need money.
But to enforce the laws of time.
Are we still together in 10 years? Am I dead?
One man is determined to stop him.
I cannot go back to save her.
This scumbag is not going back to steal money.
Stay here, Walker. My future, you're dead.
I think you planned too far ahead.
Jean-Claude Van Damme. Ron Silver.
You get him!
Mia Sara.
I will direct a movie. I will direct a film in China named... we'll name the movie The Quest. I promote the movie last year in 1993 in Cannes, and we'll be showing the movie in 1995 in Cannes on premiere. It's a big movie. It's a huge movie, and I've got great people, and we have a great story. It started in 1910, going from Marseille to Asia. It is a life achievement of a young kid from the south of France who's an orphan and who lives underground like Les Miserables and has to escape France, and he's on a boat, he's going to China, he doesn't know where China is, and with the pirates, guys like Roger Moore, now we're looking for Ephraim Abraham to be one of the pirates and fighting in China for a dream he wants to build. So the movie started in Europe, go to Asia, and the ending is in New York in 1955, 1960. So it's an epic. And that's gonna be a great movie for parents and kids. And it's also a great love story. I'd like to go back to the Ruth to see where I came from, to know I came from there. it's good to be down to earth and to meet my, again, my parents, my friends, my grandma, great-great-grandma. I think it's very nice, very exciting. But I love all different countries. You can learn from every country, different rules, and I miss the culture from Europe. But in America, I love the deal, the business, the studios. So it's...
You're mixing both.
Yeah, I live on planet Earth, and now we can cross the Atlantic in 10 hours. So it's only half a day, and we're back to Europe. Let's take advantage. My pleasure, and à bientôt à Bruxelles. Tot straks. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.